to it, I'm gonna go ahead and draw a diagram. This is what a dirndl skirt actually is. And dirndl skirt is the correct name for a gathered skirt. We call them gathered skirts, but the fashion world calls them dirndl skirts. And this is basically what they are. For your front, you have one big square. For the back, you have the two rectangles that equal the same measurement as this one big square. So basically, you can make this one big square and then cut it in half, and then you have the back. So the measurement for the square. I'm gonna turn my paper sideways so I could write better. The measurement for the square is the full waist or the full hip, it doesn't matter, measurement going across. The same here, full waist or the full hip measure. Now remember, when you cut this square out for the back, you're going to cut this in half. So you need to add at least a 5/8 inch seam allowance for this side and 5/8 inch seam allowance for that side. So keep that in mind when you make this square. So this square is going to be a little bit bigger because you're adding 5/8 on this side and 5/8 on that side. Now if you don't mind your hem, your side seam being off by 5/8 of an inch, you don't have to do this. And honestly, nobody's really gonna notice that because it's gonna be fully gathered. But if you are a stickler to it, you can go ahead and add 5/8 on this side and 5/8 on that side. Now for the length, I'm going to turn the paper again so I can write. It's going to be the total length plus 8 inches. The reason why you need the 8 inches, and this is going to be the same here and here. The reason why you need this additional 8 inches down here is for the hem. The secret to a gathered skirt draping properly is to have a large hem. So you need a 4-inch hem down here. So you're going to have 8-inch hem. 4 inches here and 4 inches here. You're going to do this on both sides. That weight from the bigger hem, let me zoom in some. Okay, now you guys can see it better. The full waist measurement at the top, or the full hip measurement, if you use the bigger number, you will have fuller skirt here. If you use a smaller number, it won't be as full. So that's up to you which size you want to use. Then the length here, plus 8 inches for the hem. You want 4 inches for the side. You're gonna turn it under and you have 4 more inches. So your total length is gonna be length plus 8 inches. And you're gonna do that for the front. And also for the back. But the only difference is when you cut your rectangle out for the back, you're going to cut this one in half to insert a zipper. And you're also gonna have your 4 inches for the hem plus another 4 inches to turn it under right here. Now, the next piece you're going to need is your waistband. I'm going to do a 3-inch waistband, so my waistband is going to be the length of the waist plus 1 inch for ease, for wearing ease, and then my width this is my length going this way. For my length, I'm going to use 12 inches or I could use, no, I'm not gonna use 12 inches, I changed my mind. For the going this way, for the length, I'm going to use, oh, you guys can't see what I'm doing. I'm going to use, I'm going to do a 3-inch waistband, so I'm going to use 6 inches plus 1/2 inch seam allowance and another 1/2 inch seam allowance, so I'm going to use 7 inches. And then I'm going to insert some interfacing in here. So you're going to need interfacing for your waistband to lay right, and I'm using an iron-on interfacing. And this will be the waist measurement, the exact waist measurement, going this way, and then this way. I'm only going to be using 3 inches. Now, let's get to the actual sewing now that you see what the pattern is going to look like. So you really don't need to make a pattern for this. All you need are the front measurement, your full hip or your full waist measure, depending on how wide you want the skirt to be, and then the full waist or hip measurement for the back as well. And you're going to cut it in half, and your length is going to be length plus 8 inches. Your waistband is going to be the actual waist measurement plus 1 inch for wearing ease, so you can move around in it. And then the width you want it to be times 2 plus 1 inch, which we're going to use a 1/2 inch seam allowance. If you want to use more than a 1/2 inch seam allowance, make sure you add that seam allowance in right here. So this is actually going to be, the waist is going to be 1 inch plus another 1 inch for a seam allowance. I forgot to add my seam allowance in this part right here. Please excuse my bad handwriting. It's been that way all my life, and I don't care to do anything about it now. And also, we're going to need a piece of iron-on interfacing that is the length of the waist, the actual length of the waist, and plus 3 inches going this way. Right, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna actually sew the skirt. I'll be right back. Okay guys, here, this is the fabric that I want to use for this skirt today, and this is one of the back panels. You remember I told you the back panel would be 1/2 of the full waist measurement, and we're making this for beauty. However, this fabric poses a bit of a problem because of the way it's printed. I don't want to lose all of this. If I were to put a 8-inch hem, it would be like this. And because I don't want to lose all of this at the bottom, the way I'm going to solve that problem is I have some other fabric that I've cut. I'm going to use 1 inch of this fabric for the hem, and then I have some more fabric that I cut that I'm going to sew down here to extend it so I can use for a hem. So when I sew this on, it's going to be like this, and then I can fold it in, have my hem, and I can still have my design element to the fabric. And if you like this fabric, this is a cotton fabric. It is woven, it is non-stretch. This fabric is also available in the TashaSewingTutorials.com online shop. So you're welcome to order some of this if you would like. And it's gonna be there, have about 20 yards. So it's gonna be there until it's sold out, and then I won't have any more. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and order that. And now I'm gonna go ahead and take care of this. I'm gonna sew this to the bottom of all of my fabric, all of my panels. I have this one, and I have this other one for the back, so I need two for the back, two smaller size for the back, and then I have this one, which is larger. You see that? The full waist measurement. Let me see if I can zoom out some more. Actually, I cannot zoom out some more, but this is the full waist measurement for the entire panel. Let me go ahead and sew the bottom hem on this, and then we'll come back and we will hem it, do the pockets, and then we'll gather it and we'll be done. This is a fairly easy skirt to make. extremely easy, 100% beginner project, but depending on what kind of fabric you use and how you actually make it, it can be casual to dressy. So I'm gonna finish this, and I'll be back in a few minutes. Okay, now that I've sewn this extension to the bottom of the fabric, the next thing we're going to do is put the pockets in. I actually have a tutorial on how to make this pocket pattern. If you were to click right there, and that will lead you to the video on how to make this pocket pattern. Now, I have decided to put the pocket about 3 inches down from the top, and you want to make sure this big part is pointing downward, and that would be right about there. So what I'm going to do is sew right into the seam allowance. This pocket is going to be sewn right directly into the seam allowance. I'm going to do that for the front part of the skirt. And let me scoot this over some so you guys can see. And this is the back part of the skirt, one of the panel. That's not the panel I want to put there. This is the back part of the skirt, the other panel. I want to make sure my pattern is facing one another, matching up really good. And you're going to do one in the opposite direction, in the exact same spot. You're going to sew this into the hem right here, right in the seam. Now, when you make your pattern, you want to make this bigger than you want the pocket to actually be, because you need seam allowance around here. So don't forget your seam allowance. I'm going to go ahead and sew a straight stitch. I'm not going to do this on camera because it's just a straight stitch. So a straight stitch all the way down on this side and on this side, and I'm going to also do the other side as well. And when I do that, we'll be back. This is so straightforward and easy, guys. A beginner first day sewing can actually make this skirt. I'll be right back. Okay, now you should have, let me zoom in some for you guys. Now you should have something like this. You have this one sewed in, this pocket side and this side of your pocket sewed in. They're mirror images of one another. And I've already ironed this side down because, you know, that's the difference between handmade and homemade, is we iron our seams. So I've ironed our seams. And now what we're going to do is we're going to sew together the side seams and the pockets at the same time. And it looks like this. You're going to have the pocket out this way. And you're going to, let me bring it over this way. You're going to handle this entire thing like it's all one piece of fabric. And now you're going to take the other side, lay it on top, right sides together, and match up your side seams and your pockets. If I can get that matched up properly, there we go. Match up your side seams and your pockets, and now we're going to sew. We're going to start here. Sew all the way down here. You're going to come around here, sew all the way around and all the way down to the end. And then your side and your pocket will all be sewed all together. And you're going to do the same thing to the other side. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to put it on the camera because it's straightforward. You sew from here, make the corner, come around here, sew all the way around, and come here. Now, I have another video on how to put this pocket in here, so if you need more detailed instructions, you can go ahead and click on the link here, which is the exact same video to show you how to make the pocket pattern. I'm going to go ahead and sew this side together, and I'm going to sew this side together as well. Right here, and then we'll be going on to the next step. Okay. One moment.
I'm back. I have sewed in the pocket. This is the pocket. We've sewed the side seams in the pocket as well. Don't forget to go back and finish your seams before you do the next step, because you don't want your seams to be showing and unraveling. And also remember, finishing up the seams will be one of the differences between your item looking homemade, artsy craftsy, and looking like a handmade product, which is what you want it to look like. I think I'm going to go ahead and do a bound seam, only because I just like the way they look. You don't have to choose that method. Choose whatever method you would like. If you need lessons, a video on the different methods of how to finish off your seams without a serger, you can click on this link right, if I can get it right. I can never get it right. Right there. There you go. If you can click on this link right there, that link will take you to a video on several different methods on how to finish your seams without a serger. And actually, that's the way handmade houses do it. They don't use a serger when they finish their seams on items that are made out of a woven fabric. Well, anyway, you see the pocket is right here, but on this side all you see is the pattern. The pocket is actually right here. If you can see that, I'm gonna zoom in some. This is where the pocket is. Now, there you go. Then when I pull it flat, you don't see anything. It's right there. Now, on the last video I did on how to sew a pocket in, I told you guys to keep this from this here inside lining from rolling to the outside. Let me see if I can get it on camera. Keep the inside lining from rolling to the front to go ahead and top stitch it. I've since learned you don't have to do that. All you have to do is sew the actual pocket. Let me turn it this way so you can, oh, you can't see it any better. You have to sew the pocket at a quarter inch seam allowance into the lining, and then you come back and use your regular half inch seam allowance to sew it together. And when you iron your seams to one side, because you know that's the next step, to iron our seams flat, when you do that, you're gonna iron this down, you won't even see the pocket at all. All you see is the print. You don't see the pocket at all. All you see is a print right here, and the pocket is actually from here to here. Once again, there it is. My hand is too big to fit in Beauty's pocket, so I'm just gonna put a pair of scissors in there. There's your pocket right there. And now we can move on to our next step. Before you do anything else is to hem it, because it's a lot easier to hem this before you put in the gathers. So I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. You're going to come around here and you're going to leave space for your zipper. Here's my zipper. I'm not going to use this entire length of zipper. I'm probably going to cut it off right here and use about this much. So my zipper is about that long, and I'm going to need 3 inches of my zipper to come up because I'm going to put in a 3-inch waistband. So my zipper's right here. So you're gonna leave out the amount that you want for your zipper, and you're going to sew all the way down here. And then after you sew this into a loop, remembering to leave your space for your zipper, you're gonna go ahead and put your seam, your hem in. So what you're going to do is just fold it up and iron and fold in however much, fold it up again, iron. Remember that I have this extension on here, so I'm only going to fold mine over about a half an inch. And then you're going to just make your hem up here. And remember, we're using this really big hem because we want the weight from the hem to make the skirt drape properly. Now, what you can do when you get to the hem is you can do a straight stitch all the way across if you don't mind doing that, or you can do a blind hem stitch. Either way it goes, you just want to make sure that you put your hem in like this. Now, I'm going to go ahead and sew this together, leaving the space for my zipper. I'll be right back. Okay, now I'm back. I have sewed this part together down here. This is the opening I left for the zip. And I've also came over here and I've ironed in my hem. I ironed in halfway, turned it up. If you don't have a pattern that runs like this, you don't have to do this way. You can just extend your fabric out 8 inches. So I rolled over my hem over 1/8 of an inch more than where the seam was. The seam is right here, and I put the fold right here. Let me zoom in some so you can see what I'm doing. This is where the hem is, where I put the extension on so I could save my print here. And when I folded it over and ironed it, I have the hem here, but I pulled it over 1/8 of an inch more. So when I hem this, and when I turn it over, you don't see the extended fabric. All you see is the print. So that's why I did that like that. Now, let me zoom back out. I'm going to sew, I think I'm gonna do a blind hem stitch right here. But you could just sew a straight stitch all the way around. And a blind hem stitch is a function on your sewing machine. You're gonna have to probably get out your manual to know how to do it. Every sewing machine has a different stitch level on it. I will actually sew this on the camera so you can see what a blind hem stitch looks like, but I can't exactly tell you what setting to put your sewing machine on. So we're gonna do that next, and then we will be literally almost done. Okay guys, I'm back. I'm gonna show you how to do the blind hem stitch on the Brother SQ91A5. I do not get an endorsement for this at all. This just happens to be the machine that I use. So I'm gonna show you how I put the blind hem stitch on it. If you have a computerized Brother machine, it came with several different types of feet. The one that you sew with normally, if I can get it into focus here. This is the J foot, and this is what you do all of your basic stitches with, well, most of your stitches with. However, you probably have a foot called the R foot. This is the foot you're going to use for your blind hem stitch. So now we're going to attach this one to the machine. And you just clip it on there, and we're going to put the thread around. And the reason, well, let me show you this before we attach it to the machine. Now the R foot, let me get it back into focus. Now the R foot has a guide on it. This thing right here is the guide. This is what it looks like on the bottom. And the reason why this guide is here, this is what it looks like on the bottom. You can come back into focus. And the reason why this guide is here is because this sits on top of the fabric to help you guide the blind hem stitch. So now we're gonna put this onto the sewing machine. And all you have to do is put it on there, drop it, clip, and it's on. And now we're going to put our setting on this particular sewing machine is 10. I know some people's sewing machine, the setting is 9, but on this particular sewing machine, my setting for the blind hem stitch is 10. Now, I'm going to zoom back out, move this out the way. When you have your fabric, you have the hem right here. I folded it up once, ironed it, folded it up twice, ironed it. Now, when you do the blind hem stitch, what you want to happen is you want the needle to only pierce here, then here, then here, all the way down. So instead of doing a straight line, it's going to be like one little dot there. And it's a little bit less intrusive than a full stitch. So in order for that to work, we have to put the fabric in a certain way. You take the fabric and you fold it right on the stitching line like this. Did you guys see what I did there?
And you have to have this lined up exactly on the stitching line. I'm gonna show you one more time. To take the fabric and you fold it under on the stitching line. Everything folds under. So now it's like this. You fold it under and you have the stitching line lined up like this evenly. And your guide is going to butt right up against the stitching line. It's not going to go on top, it's going to just butt right up against it. So let me bring the sewing machine back over here. Put it back in the camera. I'm going to do this extremely slow, on the slow setting, because I'm on the side of the sewing machine instead of in front of it like I should be. And I want to go slow so I won't mess anything up. So now, you see I'm putting the fabric in there and I'm butting it up against the guide. I'm not putting the guide on top. I'm letting the needle down. I put the sewing setting on slow. If you have a computerized Brother sewing machine, you can actually sew on the machine with a button to sew instead of using your presser foot, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm putting it on slow. I'm going to lower my needle and I'm going to sew a little bit. And I'm gonna let you guys see what it looks like. And if you can see, every now and then, the needle sews on to the right of the fabric, but every now and then it skips over to the left. It stays on the right side of the guide, and every few stitches it skips over to the left. And you want it to do that because when it skips over to the left, that's when it's actually piercing the fabric. Now I'm going to, come back. Show you guys what it looks like. One moment, I'll be right back. Okay, I tried to use a red thread on the top and a white on the back, hoping you guys could see what was going on, but actually I can't see any of this thread on the camera. Those little dots, those are the piercings from the red thread, and on the back those little dots are the piercings from the white thread. And when you open it up, and then if you open it up like this, hold on, let me get you on camera. If you open it up like this, you can see the actual sewing line. But when you come over to the right side, all you have are those little dots. See there? Those dots are all you have. Now all I have to do is go back in and iron this out, and you will hardly even notice the hem. So this is why I did the blind hem stitch instead of the straight stitch, because it's less intrusive of a hem, especially when I have a pattern like this. So I'm going to go ahead and finish it. See, there's the back side again. You can see that. And here is the front again. You can hardly notice anything. The stitches are there. Let me see if I can find a spot. Yeah, there's a green spot. You might can see those little white dots right there, but let me see if I can zoom in some more. Those white dots are the hem. So that's why I wanted to use a blind hem stitch on this skirt. So when I zoom back out, you will hardly even notice that they're there. So imagine when you're wearing it. So let me go ahead and finish hemming this, and then we'll do the gathering, and then we'll be put the waistband on and the zipper,
okay,
and we'll be done.
Okay, we're going to do the gathering for the skirt, and instead of doing it where I put three gathering stitches right here like we normally do, this time we're going to actually use the dental floss method. You put the dental floss on your fabric and you just zigzag across it. Make sure your needle does not go inside on the dental floss, just like this. And when you're done with that, you can easily gather it up. Let me go ahead and finish it, and then I'll come back on screen and you'll see how I gather it with the dental floss. Okay, now I'm done zigzagging over the top of the dental floss,
And the reason why I'm showing you this method is because when you have a thick fabric, I know some of the people who want this tutorial, because it was a requested tutorial, want to do this in a thick fabric. So this is what you're gonna do. You zigzag over the top of the dental floss, and then you just pull it, and it easily gathers up your fabric really fast. Oh, I forgot to mention, before you pull it, you're gonna put a knot on this end with the thread and the dental floss, because you don't want it to pull it out. And because this dental floss has a waxy coating on it, it just glides right through the fabric. So you just pull it down, gather, pull, get back in the camera, and gather, and pull the dental floss, and gather. And it's that simple. You're going to gather it all the way around until you get it to the size that you need the finished piece to be, and that will be the size of your waist plus 1 inch for wearing ease. You see how easy that is? Pull it and gather. One more. And it just slides down just like that. And then we're going to pull it and it gathers. Now when I come back on screen, I'm going to have this gathered down to the size that I need it to be. And this dental floss trick is just a lot easier to do than having to sew in three lines. If you're having a heavy fabric, having to sew in three lines of basting and then having to gather. Now I need this to gather down to 21 inches. So I'm going to go off camera, going to go ahead and gather this up, and then I'll be back and we will be putting the waistband onto the skirt and then the zipper, and then we're finished. So we're at the home stretch, guys.
Now that I have the skirt nicely gathered, as you can see here, it's going to be pretty full because even though I used her waist measurement, it's going to be pretty full. Now it's time to go ahead and put the waistband on. So let me move this out of the way and come back with the waistband. Now on the first part of the video, I said I was going to make the waistband 3 inches wide. Now I've rethought it and I've decided to go ahead and do 2 inches wide. I didn't have enough fabric to make the entire waistband one full piece, so I had to put a seam in it. Now if you have to put the seam like this, make sure your seam is in the middle and put this in the center of the waist so it can look decent, because if you put it offside, it's not going to look right. So if you have to seam it, make sure you put this in the middle, and also make sure you finish your seams. Notice how I finished my seam off. Now the next thing we're going to do is after you decide how wide you want your waistband, I have a 5/8 inch seam allowance here on both sides, and I did that because I want to make sure that I get the gathers all the way enclosed into the waistband. So I have a 5/8 inch seam allowance. Usually I like to work with 1/2 inch, but technically in the sewing world, fashion clothing sewing world, 5/8 inch seam allowance is a standard, and basically, honestly, there's a reason for that, so stick to that if you can. So I've ironed in my seam allowances, and then I folded it in half and ironed it again, and I ironed the crease in right here for the top of the waistband. But I want this waistband to have some body to it, so I'm going to add in some fusible interfacing. Not double fuse, only one side. So I'm only have interfacing that you fuse on one side. I've cut it to fit one side of the
one side of the waistband, which is, I'm going to iron in just like this. And then after I iron that in, I'm going to sew this part. Actually, I'm going to sew this part to the waistband. I really don't think it matters if the interfacing is facing the body or facing the outside of the dress. I just like it to be facing the outside of the dress, but it really doesn't matter. Either way it goes, you're gonna add some stability to your waistband when you use this interfacing. So I'm going to go ahead and iron this in, and I only cut enough for one side. You don't have to have it on both sides. You can if you want to, but I'm just gonna have it on one side like this, and then I'm going to iron it in, and then we'll go to the next step. I'll be back, one moment. Now I have the interfacing ironed into the waistband, and this waistband actually is longer than what I need. I made it really long because I wanted to make sure I get this seam in the middle, so I'm going to go ahead and take the middle of the waistband and start pinning it to the middle of the skirt. And now this, even if you don't use pins, this is a time where you're going to want to use pins, because you want to keep the gathers, your gathers right where you put them. So I'm going to take the waistband and I'm going to take the center of the waistband and start pinning it to the skirt. And I'm going to do that all the way around, just like this. And I'm going to use a lot of pins because I want to make sure my gathers stay exactly where I put them, because I'm just kind of OCD like that, but I want them to stay exactly where I put them so they can look the way I want it to look. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and then I'm gonna come back and sew the waistband onto the skirt. We're gonna flip it up like this, and I'm going to apply the zipper right here, and then After we apply the zipper, we fold this down and top stitch. So actually, I'm doing this the wrong way. I want the interfacing on the outside, so I need to start over. It doesn't really matter. That's just the way I like it, because I don't like the way the stiff interfacing feels up against my body. So I feel like nobody else likes it either, so I try to make sure the interfacing goes on the outside. However, if it doesn't matter to you, either way it goes, it doesn't matter. So I'm gonna pin it like that, sew it on. I'm not going to put it in the video so we can save time, because this is a fairly long video, because I'm trying to get the entire skirt finished in one video instead of having two and three parts, because you guys don't tend to like to see watch the second part. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this, and I'll be back, show you what it looks like, put in a zipper, and wait for Beauty to come home from school, and we're done. I'll see you guys in a minute. Okay, now I have the waistband sewn in. As you can see, I have the interfacing in the front, and the part without the interfacing will be in the back. Here it is. There's the outside. There's the inside. Now when I fold this over, I'll fold it over like this. Fold it over like this. Fold in my seam allowance, and then I'm going to fold this over and top stitch everything down. So this is how it looks on the inside, nice and neat. And on the outside, nice and neat as well. Let me turn it this way. I'm sitting on the side of the camera. Nice and neat as well. So you fold it under, top stitch everything in place, and then you're going to iron this down so it'll be neat. Before I do that, however, I'm going to add the zipper into the waistband. Well, I'm going to cut this down to size. This is actually a lot longer, like I was saying, a lot longer than it needs to be. So I'm going to add the zipper, cut this down to size, and then I'm going to sew. I'm going to cut it down to size, fold it in like this, and you didn't see that on camera. Cut it down to size. This is the end. I'm going to fold it in like this to enclose the raw edges. And then I'm going to top stitch from here all the way around to the other side. And then the dress will be done. And when Beauty comes home from school, she can model it for you guys. And actually, it's raining really bad today, so the video might be on delay. I'm gonna have to wait till it's nice day outside so we can go outside and take video so you can see what it looks like, because it's gonna hang really nice. I can tell already before it's even done how nice this is going to drape, because we did put the 4-inch hem in there. Now, if you wanted it to drape even more nicely, to put extra weight in there, you can purchase a really tiny, really, really tiny chain and hand sew the chain, like tack a few links down at the end here, all the way around, and it'll drape even nicer. That's actually what they do in the couture houses when they make these dresses like this, to make them drape really nicely. They sew a really small chain on the inside. If you do this, make sure this chain is not gonna rust on you and ruin your garment when you wash it. So either you're gonna have to dry clean it, or you're gonna have to make sure that's a chain that's like titanium or stainless steel, something like that, something that won't rust on you when you wash it. So that's a little tip. I don't do that for Beauty's dresses because most of them are casual. But if you want to make a really, really nice, beautiful outfit and you want it to drape really nicely, that is one tip to make it even heavier in the hem by sewing a tiny chain in the bottom on the inside. So if you were to do the chain, you're going to put it in between this layer and this layer on the inside and hand sew it in. And also, I don't just want to let you see this again. You see how nicely that hem is? I mean, zoom it in. You see how nicely that hem lays on the inside and then on the outside? It's undetectable. The hem is right here, and I have you guys zoomed in quite a bit and you can barely see it at all. So that's my advice on these kind of skirts. And actually, the longer the skirt is, the more heavier I would want the drape to be. So take that advice as well. I'm gonna go ahead and put the zipper in. I'm not going to put the zipper on camera because, like I was saying, I'm trying not to have the video too long. However, if you want me to make an additional video on how to insert the zipper, I'm going to use this kind of zipper. It's not going to be an invisible because I happen to like the exposed zipper look that's popular nowadays. So I'm going to put this zipper in. However, if you would like for me to make a video on how to put in an exposed zipper, a lap zipper, are in an invisible zipper, let me know and I will make a technical video for that. So let me know in the comments. I'm gonna go ahead and install the zipper and I'll be right back. Okay, now my zip is inserted and it works. It's in there properly. And I have the exposed zipper like I like. This is the new style now, and I think it's pretty cute, so that's why I did it. Now, However, when I put my zipper in, I stopped it just below the waistband because I want to fold this over like this, wrap it around. Well, actually, I want to cut this to make it fit and fold this over like this. And like this, and then sew like that. And when I do it, it's actually going to be this short. And this side is going to be this short. And I'm going to have a little gap right there. So that's kind of like a design element that I put in there. However, if you want to bring your zipper all the way up to the waistband, you can. That's why we sew this, the waistband on first. And you would put your zipper all the way up to here. Let me zoom in. You would sew your zipper all the way up to here to the fold. And then you would insert it. So now all I have to do is fold this waistband, the seam allowance in once, and then fold it on top and top stitch, and then I'm done. And actually, I did not mention this earlier, but I'm going to mention it now. You may want to go ahead after you sew the waistband in, if I can find it, and just pull this dental floss all the way out. Once you sew the waistband in, your gathers are exactly where you want them to be. You don't have to pull the dental floss out, but you may want to. If I were selling the outfit, I would pull the dental floss out. If I am just making it for myself, I would probably, it wouldn't really bother me. And all you do is you cut that knot off. I'm gonna do it now. You cut the knot off that you put the dental floss in, and you just pull it all the way out, just like this. And it comes all the way out. And it's gonna take me a while. Oh, I didn't take the other knot out. That's why. That's why I'm having an issue pulling my dental floss out. But you just pull it all the way out, just like that. And it comes out, and then your gathers stay because you've already sewn it in there. Now you don't have, like I'm saying before, you don't have to pull it out if you don't want to. But there it is. Mine is already out. It's just that simple. That's how fast I got it out. See, I have the dental floss out. Since I sewed the waistband on, the gathers are staying exactly where I put them at. So let me go ahead and finish this. And then when I'll come back and show you what it looks like. And when we get a nice day outside, I'll go ahead and film Beauty Wearing It Outside. If it's not a nice day by Monday, this is the Friday before, I'm filming this the Friday before Mother's Day. If we don't have a nice day outside before Monday, I'm just gonna go ahead and film her on the inside, but you may not be able to see how nice it looks because the lighting in here is not that good for filming. So, let me finish this and I'll be back and I'll let you see what it looks like. Okay guys, the skirt is complete. Here is the front. Here is the back. And there's that little gap. Oh, I need to get that thread off. There's a little gap I was telling you about in the waistband. So when she puts it on, it's gonna go like this. Oh, let me zoom in so you can see what I'm talking about. Here's a little gap in the waistband that I was talking about when I stopped the zipper right here. So when she puts it on, it's gonna go like that. I think that's pretty cute. And there's that invisible hem right there. So overall, this is a really cute skirt. I like the way it came out. And don't forget, if you like this fabric, you can find it in the TashaSewingTutorials.com in the store there. I have about 20 yards of this. Now once that sells out, I don't know if I'll be able to get any more because I got it at a really nice price at a warehouse locally, but they didn't have that much. I think I bought all of it. And if you notice here, Like I was always telling you guys, make sure you match up your patterns. This right here is a seam, and this is the best as I can match the pattern up. And I had to make this actually in two panels in the front, even though you're supposed to only make it in one panel. If you can, make it in one panel in the front, but if not, match up the seams again, just like I did right here with the pattern. And let me find the side seam. Yeah, this is a side seam. The pattern is matched up nicely. And the pocket's actually right there. There you go. And I'm going to put a pair of scissors in there so you can see it. There's the pocket right there. And when you take the scissors out, the pocket disappears. Also on the other side, and the reason why this pocket looks like that is because I matched up the pattern really well. And the way I installed the pocket, I ironed it down after I installed it, like I was telling you guys. There is another seam on the side, and the pocket, once again, is right there. And then once you take the scissors out, the pocket disappears. So, and let me zoom back out. Don't forget the 4-inch hem. Now you can make this skirt in any kind of fabric you want to make it in. You can make it in the woven fabric like I did now. You can make it in the jersey knit stretch fabric as well. No matter what kind of fabric you make it in, you always want to put the 4-inch hem in it, which means you're going to have the length plus the 8 inches. So don't forget that, because that is one of the secrets to making a really nice dirndl skirt or gathered skirt. The secret is to make this a really large hem, and if you want it to hang even more nicely, to put the tiny chain in it like I was talking about before. And the other secret is how we install the pocket. When you do the blind hem stitch, the hem comes out like this. And I'm actually going to do a video showing you how to do this by hand, because I know everybody does not have a blind hem foot. But I will make a video on how to do that by hand, because you can do that by hand. Well, that's it for this part of the video. The next time we come back, you'll see Beauty wearing the skirt. And then that'll be it. I'll see you guys when she comes home.
And now here Beauty is again with the petticoat on underneath her skirt. You can see how it's fluffed out a little bit. This petticoat is really small. It's only has like, no, put your dress down, baby. It only has 10 layers on it. If you want a really full petticoat, you're gonna need at least 20 layers. So, but this is it with a 10-layer petticoat. If you want a link to that video on, no, Beauty, put your arms down. If you want a link to the video for the petticoat, the link is right there. Just click on that link right there where I'm pointing to, and you'll take the link to that video. And now we're going to take a video of her without the petticoat on, so you can see how nicely it drapes. Now this is a short one, and the longer it is, the more it would drape. And we're going to take the petticoat off and come back. And we're filming inside the house because it's raining really bad outside. We're under a thunderstorm warning and it's really bad. So if you hear any thunder or loud noises, that's what that is. We'll be right back, one moment. Now here we are again with the dress without the petticoat. Can you be still a little bit, Beauty? And see how nicely it drapes? And Beauty's moving around, so you really can't tell. But it drapes really nicely. If it were had a smaller hem, it would be limp against the body. This bigger hem is what's making the difference in the world. Okay, Beauty, put your skirt down so everybody can see. All right, guys, that's it. We'll see you guys next time. Say it with me, Patrick, Maris, and Beauty. As usual, happy sewing.